la. Good morning, everybody. Yeah.
I'm a huge Ronnie fan. I really am. Ronnie, I'm very open sexually, but your sex tips are the most disturbing audio since JD's wedding vows. People are giving you a lot of shit about using Dean Cain's body for those posters. It was actually an even trade. I don't know if you know this. Dean Cain has been using your body as proof that leprechauns exist. Ronnie wants to open an animal hospital someday. Ronnie, the 9/11 hijackers had a more well thought out retirement. No, you'll be great at it. I love the idea of you with an animal hospital. Some little kid brings in their sick pet gerbil and you immediately shove it up at your ass to keep it warm. It's beautiful. Ronnie, you've pulled more things out of your ass than Sal explaining the Civil War. Ronnie, you do take your job very seriously. That's what I appreciate about you. You, when you drive, you treat Howard like royalty, specifically Princess Diana.
That is true.
Ronnie, you're 69. What's it like to know that you're going to be outlived by your fiance and most houseflies? I just want to say before I go, I am a huge fan of the show and you, and you're truly beloved, Ronnie. Like, you really are. And I know that even long after Howard retires, you're still going to be able to draw a crowd with a crayon in your assisted living facility. So that's something.
Have a throne in here from Ronnie's roast.
When you see the dildo throne, there are 69 dildos on that throne. We don't know what to do with it.
There are 200. I got a whole tutorial on the throne yesterday and how it was made.
Tell people 69.
69.
In other words, that's what I'm going with here.
Right.
I should have discussed
it. It's the 69 throne.
Yeah, 69. It's 69 dildos.
69.
But really 200. But
200 just, something.
269.
And you know,
that's a lot of dildos.
Everything has to be done on a budget.
Right.
We're now dildo manufacturers.
We manufactured over 200 dildos for the chair that Ronnie sat on, and it only cost us 75 cents. It's a miracle.
Yeah, an artist worked on this throne.
We had an artist. What artist?
They said an artist went over those dildos.
Banksy.
Yeah, Vincent van Gonad.
Wow.
It was putting in extra veins and all kinds of things.
Vincent van Gonad, I never heard of
him. Yeah, he cut off one of his balls.
Yes, Brody, you're on the air.
Yeah, I wanted to ask Mehmet, Mr. Great Ideas, everything. How could you take Friday off, like to play Red Dead 2?
I heard you had a fabulous day off.
I did.
That people are allowed to take a day off around here.
Literally my first vacation day of the entire year. Give me a break.
Is it true you took you spent the whole weekend in front of the TV playing these video games?
Yes.
And how did you do? Did you win any of the games?
Well, you don't win them. That's not how it works.
Really. What happened?
It's like a role-playing game.
I see. And what was your role? Who were you?
I'm a cowboy.
You're a cowboy.
Yes.
I'm a douchebag.
You're a douchebag.
You're a cowboy. And what are the other people?
I have a gang of cowboy friends.
There you go. Yeah, I can't wait for these good ideas.
The game is really, really good. It's so detailed. The horse you ride around on?
Yes.
He has balls. Like, they've added balls to the horse.
That's important to you?
And not only do they add balls, but like if you're in a cold town, the balls get tiny.
Really?
Yeah, like this is how good video games have gotten.
You're watching those balls a lot.
And I understand from the gossip around here, you ignored your girlfriend's texts all weekend.
No, I did not ignore her text. I told her ahead of time, I'm spending the weekend as a cowboy. Don't disturb me.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, are you on your way to being the greatest cowboy? You are.
Yeah.
How would you know?
Well, I'm not losing the game. My gang
You're still
is getting
in it.
Bigger. It tells you what percentage you've bonded with your horse, and I'm 100% bonded with my
horse. Isn't that fabulous, Robin?
Yes. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Well, brushing those horse balls.
Yeah, well, you know what? If you suck horse cock, you get a very good bond with the horse.
Exactly.
Oh, John wants to tell you something real quick. Go ahead, John.
Hey, Mehmet, I just wanted to say I'm totally on your side. definitely way more important to bond with that cartoon horse and his balls than your hot girlfriend.
Let me tell you something. He's gotten very close to his cartoon horse, and he's one of the top cowboys in the game.
Right.
That horse is so detailed.
Yeah. What is your horse's name?
I'm not getting into what my horse's name is.
Why?
Because will we be able to find
why?
Him?
You're ashamed.
No. Of course I'm ashamed.
What is your horse's name?
I'm not.
Come on.
I'm giving enough.
That's too personal?
Yeah. I'll tell you off the air.
No, tell me now. I don't give a fuck about your horse's name off the air. Now you turn me off. Come on.
Stop, dude.
What's your horse's name? What's the big deal?
Okay, I named it after the girl I'm dating, but I didn't even know it was a guy horse. I didn't see the balls till afterwards.
You did.
So what?
So why are you embarrassed by that?
Because it's silly.
That you named your horse after the woman you're dating?
Can we stop?
You used her real name?
Well,
her first name.
Yeah.
Is it weird to see balls on your girlfriend?
Yeah, a little bit.
Is that why you're embarrassed?
Well, I'm embarrassed because it's a cheesy thing that I was just doing by myself.
Wow, of all the things you've admitted, and that's the
and
thing
that's
that embarrasses
you.
Please, I'm embarrassed about everything. Don't worry about that.
Oh, my goodness. Richard with this Halloween is unbelievable. I mean, you know, I realize Richard is a very rare adult. He's an adult, but has a child's mentality. Like, just the other week, Richard and his wife went to Orlando to attend Halloween Horror Night at Universal Studios. And this was the 22nd year in a row Richard has attended this event.
Yeah, he's very proud of that.
Yeah. And Halloween Horror Night, of course, only takes place at night. During the day, Richard kept himself in the Halloween mood by reading the Halloween edition of Women's Day magazine by the hotel pool.
Oh.
And he wears headphones as he reads the magazine so he can hear scary Halloween sound effects.
Right.
This one is called Cannibal Eating Person. This is what he's listening to by the pool. I mean, this is nuts. You went to haunted houses all night. You don't want a break from Halloween. You laid by the pool and read about Halloween.
Oh, I immersed myself in the Halloween universe.
Here's another tape. This is Richard sitting by the pool. This is what he's listening to. Why is that Halloween, the cuckoo clock?
Well, for me, it reminds me of the movie Evil Dead. There's a scene in Evil Dead where the clock goes crazy.
Did they have an Evil Dead haunted house?
They have before in other years.
That's my favorite.
Oh, it's the best.
You know what this reminds me of? I think of, like, what must the noise in Fred's head sound like? And I think this is it. I do. Is it, Fred?
No, it's not.
Okay.
Well, the thing is, I didn't only listen to that stuff by the pool. I listened to these sound effects since
all weekend.
Labor Day. Yeah. Right. Well, on the way to work and stuff. And it's funny. And
do you have a calendar that, like, says start listening to Halloween sound effects?
I just know around the end of August.
February, let's start looking for your sound effects. The delay
end of August.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But sometimes that, like, there'll be a lady screaming in my earphones, and it's so loud, people will look at me like, what the hell are you listening to?
This insane song is called Season of the Witch Jingle.
From Halloween 3. Oh, it's one of my favorite songs.
And this is on your headphones when you're sitting by the pool.
Constantly, yeah.
This.
Happy Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. Happy, happy Halloween, Silver Shamrock. Happy, happy Halloween, Halloween. Happy Halloween, Silver Shamrock.
It's almost time, kids.
The clock is ticking.
You love that.
Yeah, I love it. It's from Halloween 3, which is my favorite
Christ,
movie ever.
Jesus Christ, you're such a fucking weird guy. Can you imagine, Robin, devoting this much time to this?
The only reason he's not living in a basement, Howard, is you.
I know. That's true.
Thank you. Well, even worse, I was in a storage unit.
Yeah, this guy was living...
I would have killed for a basement.
He was living in a storage unit. No bathroom, nothing.
Yeah. I'm a Halloweeny, what can I say?
No, you're more than that.
No, you're a guy who goes to every weird thing. And anything you do normal, you have to weird it up.
Yeah,
there's
I mean,
a lot of people like me.
Well, there are a lot of people like you. And, you know, they're called seven-year-olds. You know?
Ronnie, the limo driver, Munn. I didn't come here to bury you, Ronnie. We all know that's Thursday.
Ronnie watched his parents have a threesome with the neighbor through the bottom of the door.
Right.
And that's not the weird part. The weird part, he was eye level with the bottom of the door. Ronnie wants to open and run an animal hospital in Las Vegas because, really, why should humans be the only ones with shitty luck in that town? Ronnie's also killing it on Twitter these days, and by it, I mean women's sex drive. Ronnie loves NASCAR. He hangs with drivers like Tony Stewart. He even has a nickname for Tony. He calls him Smoke. Tony has a nickname for Ronnie. He calls him Loser Fucking Wannabe. Ronnie's love of racing started as a kid when he got Ben Hur's autograph after a race.
Like
I made him laugh.
Amazing when I look at George and see that he is 81 years old. I am amazed every time. I mean, this guy looks like he's
wonderful.
25 years younger than his
Just
guy.
Take care of yourself and
give
Mother
us
Nature
quickly what we need to do. We need to eat properly. Eat we need properly. To exercise. You're still walking a lot?
Walking a lot in the fitness center every morning.
Really?
And keep the mind
still
going.
Doing 100 push-ups?
Yes.
100 push-ups a day?
Push-ups and 50 sit-ups.
Every day?
Every day.
At 81?
At 81.
Look at you. Do you have any belly fat?
Oh, yeah. You know, that's the thing that comes with age. My stomach is popping out. I mean, really, I went to my doctor and said, isn't there something I can eat or not eat to get this down?
Slim it down a little, yeah.
I'm still doing my sit-ups.
Isn't it interesting that you still care? I think that's what keeps you young and vivacious. You are 81 and looking much younger because you care that your stomach is getting better.
We want to be enjoying life.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Some people are always saying they're tired, you know?
Yes.
Well, Howard is one of them.
Always tired.
Oh, you're always
tired right now, yes.
I wouldn't believe it. I mean, you're so
I feel
vibrant.
Tired. Well, I don't know what it is. I just don't feel awake.
Well, maybe it's contagious.
Who knows? Who knows?
I should visit you more often.
JD sends me a clip yesterday. I wouldn't even play it on the air. Some guy on a sports show is interviewing a young, famous, either football player or basketball player. I don't know what he was. And he goes, you know, who's your favorite shock jock or something like that? The guy goes, oh, what about Howard Stern? That's my guy. He goes, who's Howard Stern?
JD sent you that?
Yeah. What was the guy's name, JD, you sent me? That horrible tape ruined my day.
Well, sorry.
You made Ball feel like he wasn't famous.
I don't know what you want mentioned sent to you, don't you, though?
I have no idea what you just said.
First of all, the player was Kerryon Johnson. He's a running back for the Detroit Lions.
Who's he?
Well, he's a
I never heard of him.
Well, there you go.
You know, that can send someone with an ego like mine right down into the gutter.
Yeah, JD doesn't get it.
No. Get what?
Yeah, here's what you don't get. Bolf is trying to beat his depression. Suddenly I see an email from my man JD who sends me clips of my name mentioned.
Here's something about me.
You go, in case you're having a great day, listen to this.
Enjoy.
I blame you for my bad day yesterday.
Oh, I apologize. Do you want me to not send
No, I stop it, of course. Send me everything.
All right.
But not that.
Howard.
What?
There are some who say that they heard JD laughing while he was listening to that clip yesterday.
Oh, give me a break.
Okay, whatever. I don't remember, guffawing or anything, but...
But you did laugh.
Howard, there are others who think he was laughing while he was sending it to you as well.
No, give me a break.
Who are these others?
These are shitsters.
JD and I were discussing the clip yesterday, and he was definitely having a good time with it.
Wow.
Yeah, because he's happy. Let me tell you something, JD. If people don't know who I am, you're out of a job.
You are. You know what?
You apologize for sending that to me. I'm sorry.
Will's a liar, and I apologize.
Will's not lying. Will doesn't lie about stuff.
No, bullshit.
Will's my boy. That's my son right there. Not you anymore. Will.
You can have him.
Hey, by the way, I do have one last surprise for Ronnie on his birthday. This is all meant... Ronnie, do you want to see your mom one more time?
Oh, yeah!
Would you like to see your mom?
Yeah, bring her in.
Bring her in. All right, your mom is here. She loves Ronnie.
She loves him so
she
much.
She was caught in a threesome with Ronnie. There she is. She's here. She's here with her doctor.
Assholes! You! Right. You! You! You all fucking suck!
You yell! You yell, Ronnie's mom, you yell just like Ronnie. You
what?
Just say,
what?
You!
Fuck you.
This is Ronnie's birthday!
Right.
Have some fucking respect!
Right.
I'm his mother!
What, you love Ronnie?
My little boy!
Yeah, you love him.
Fucking assholes! Good thing this room is full of cunts! Because Ronnie loves him! He loves being surrounded by cunts!
Ronnie's mom. Ronnie's mom, I love you. Everyone loves you. But you could see where Ronnie grew up. You all talk the same. And you yell and you're excited.
Yeah! Because you're all sucking fucking motherfuckers.
Right.
That's why. Right. And you, Rob, look at you.
Yeah, tell her.
Yeah. You do the fucking news. I got some news for you.
What's that?
You're a cunt.
What? Rob is sweet, Rob.
Let's get this shit started.
Let's get this shit started. Yes. That's Ronnie.
What
that's
are you fucking looking at?
Who? Ronnie's mom, you say, let's get this shit started. Did he learn that from you?
Yeah.
Yeah. What a mom.
Nikki Glaser.
Nikki Glaser.
She was on Dancing with the Stars.
Right.
She should be dancing on my son's cock. It's his birthday, bitch.
Right.
Do some Lisa Lampanella retiring from comedy. Here's a question. What took you so long? Lisa Lampanelli, yeah. I'm fucking sick of you. And what the fuck happened to your hair? That smurf shit on your head? Looks like the inside of my toilet bowl. Jim Brewer. Oh, Jim Brewer. Yeah, he loves AC Doocy. I seen you, you fuck. Yeah, with his fucking goat boy. Oh, that was good. How about this character? Old washed up hack. You're more familiar with that than Jim Brewer.
You love Ronnie so much. You eviscerated all of these people who
that's
made fun
right.
of your son.
So much for now. Short. Howard, here's a question. Making fun of his height. He can't help it. You know what? All the men are short.
Right.
That's perfect pussy munching height. That's like a good manners.
There's nothing, I want to say this, there is nothing like a mother's love for her son, and you have shown that today with Ronnie.
I love Ronnie. He's a good boy. He rescued squirrels.
He did?
He's got a squirrel rescue. And it's in my cunt. I got a couple up there. He finds squirrels. They go right the fuck up my cunt.
All right. Well,
he
you
loves animals.
Loves
he loves animals.
He does. I know that about him. Yeah.
And in closing, may I say, Howard, happy birthday to my sweet little boy. And shame on each and every fucking one of you.
Easy.
Yeah, you fucking son of a bitches.
Well, look. Get out of here. No,
I don't
know.
Get her out of here.
Yeah, she's dangerous. She has a dildo on, and she attacked with Lisa Lampanelli and Nikki Glaser with her dildo. Wow. Wow. Ronnie. I'm not saying this to be mean, but here's the tip of the day. I've heard from a couple of different people already.
Yeah.
You're wearing too much cologne today. It's like very, very smelly. Too much.
Yeah, okay. Anything else?
What cologne do you use?
Mambo.
Mambo.
Claiborne.
What's the name of the cologne? Ronbo?
No, Mambo.
Oh, Mambo. Munbo. Yeah.
Munbo.
Hey, you got any of that Munbo?
Well, it's actually discontinued now. They discontinued it.
Mambo?
But you can still get it like on these websites, these...
It's that great?
He's into his Munbo.
Yeah, I buy like 4 or 5 bottles at a time because you can only get it on the internet.
How much do you use?
Man,
no, I don't pour it on. Will you stop it?
Listen to this. This is from the Mambo website.
The smell lasts 6 to 10 hours.
Wow.
And the recommended age group is mature.
Really?
Like,
so
it's good for the older man.
They know it's for
Ronnie. Dude, let me tell you something.
Let me tell you something.
Every chick
loves it.
That smelled this shit.
Yeah.
And I'm not shitting you. I swear to God. From strippers to regular chicks.
To regular
love
chicks.
Love it.
They go crazy.
They go crazy for it.
Let me tell you girls something. I'm going to give you a warning. I'm wearing Mambo. Yeah.
By Claiborne. Wow. You better send me a case.
Mambo was sold at Target, it says here.
That's not anymore.
Target.
Not anymore.
No more Target.
No more.
It's $29.99.
No.
$29.99.
No, no. It was $70. It used to be $70 a bottle.
Yeah. Yeah. What is it, Ralph?
Hey, now?
Hey, now.
Who wears cologne to work?
I don't know. No one.
That's kind of weird. And
yeah. Very weird.
You don't know who you're going to meet.
Very weird.
Mambo Cologne by Liz Claiborne. Mambo for Men is an up-tempo twist of bergamot and zesty lime.
Wow. Roddy, why are you wearing that to work?
Why don't you go to hell, Ralph?
Why
don't you shut the fuck up?
Why would you cologne yourself?
Why don't you go throw up in Howard's house?
Because I did that already.
Yeah, because you're an asshole.
I'm going to throw up in your car now.
Yeah, yeah. You'll never be in my car again. That I can tell you.
I wear Mambo for mature men. What's he doing? He's not mature.
The only thing mature about him is his cologne.
Wouldn't you love to see him going into Target and buying Mambo? Like, wouldn't you like to see him just tanking up on Mambo?
Excuse me. To the Mambo counter.
With
excuse
one of those carts cleaning out the shelves.
Excuse me, pimply-faced teenager. Where do you have your supplies of Mambo? We've discontinued Mambo. What the fuck?
Bullshit.
Where am I going to get my Mambo? Chicks love it.
Could you check in the stock room? Do you have any left?
Could you call some other stores? Maybe they got some back stock they didn't send back to the factory.
How much Mambo you got at home?
Can you let this die?
How much Mambo you got at home? How much Mambo you got at home? How much you got left?
Well, if you go on one of these, I forget who told me this. If you go on a cosmetic website, they tell you if you can buy as much cologne you want and put it in the refrigerator.
Yeah.
It'll last for 5 years.
You've got cologne Mambo in the refrigerator?
Stockpiled.
How much Mambo do you have?
I must have about, right now, about 10 bottles.
Oh, my God.
He has a special fridge.
Do you feel Mambo has become sort of your thing? And it's your lucky thing, too, when you meet chicks?
I don't know. Dude, listen.
Hey, Ronnie, how could you live long enough?
Do what? Please. I don't want to talk to him.
Can I smell Ronnie? I mean, can I just...
Go ahead.
I know who told you now.
Couple of people said it.
But I know it was Gary.
Was it?
Because I walked in.
I don't want to say.
It was Gary. I know it was. Because me and Gary got real close in the hall before.
Ronnie absolutely positively was not me.
It wasn't you? Absolutely. Oh, because I know I got real close to you.
I would tell you.
You know what? I don't care. I don't care about
Fred,
cologne.
What are you
I don't
saying?
Give a shit.
Hold on. Let me pace it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. About 7 feet away, you can smell him.
You smell him there?
From about 7 feet.
Oh, bullshit. Now I know it's bullshit.
How'd you find Mambo? Like, how did you get turned on to it?
Somebody gave it to me as a gift a long time ago.
Nice. Good for you, man. 20 Thanks. Bucks, you got girls eating out of the palm of your hand. I knew there was a secret.
Yep.
Now
There's
I
a
know.
Secret.
Now everyone knows.
Yep.
Wondered what the
And you had to let it out now. Wow. Thanks.
Mambo.
All the guys are going to get Mambo. Yeah,
I got to take a break.
You're out of competition again.
Mama loves Mambo. Look at him sway with it, get so gay with it, shout no lay with it, wow.
Do you want to pitch an idea right now?
One of the most common emails I get from people, they want, I mean, they're not nice, but they say they want to punch me in the face or beat me up.
Go ahead.
So I figure, $100,000, one lucky fan gets to completely try to kick my ass. That would be fun. Oh, come on. See, we're done.
No, that would be fun.
You guys are going to pretend that wouldn't be cool.
I didn't say anything.
Nobody said a word.
Can't we consider for a moment?
Okay, I'm a cowboy.
Richard wants to know how much for him to smack you in the face with his cock.
What would you take?
Throw out some numbers. I mean, I'm a team player.
But Sal takes the cock for free.
I mean, we've got to be in the thousands.
Right. Are you naked over there, Richard? Oh, I see.
He's getting his money out.
Richard hates me now, too.
I'll get naked. No, we're going to make a great bit together right now.
How much money do you have?
43.
I'll give 100 toward the
44, actually.
I got 100 in my wallet.
I have
100.
If you want to do $5,000 by the end of the day.
Why $5,000? We just came up with $543.
I mean, I want my pockets full.
You don't want your cock.
You can go out to dinner with $543.
You're
going to
get smacked.
I'd rather go out to dinner, 100 times.
Yeah, but a new horse. Hey, listen.
Get a real horse.
A great bit on this show is priceless.
Benjy says he wants to let Richard slap his face with his dick for free.
Team player. He would do it for free. He's jealous.
Okay, Benjy, come in, Benjy. Here, I'm going to show you my boy, Benjy.
You get out, my man. Benjy
now watch Benjy.
Happy
watch Halloween. This guy. Benjy, you want to take a cock to your face just to show this guy where it's at?
I do not want to steal your moment, but I would happily do it.
Well, are you willing to take a cock to your face?
I really think the audience would enjoy
Benjy. All right,
Benjy,
show him how it's done. Go ahead, Richard.
Is this the best spot? Is this a good angle?
Should we do it on the cock?
You sit wherever you want. Sit in the cock chair. Sit in the cock chair. Sit in Ronnie's throne.
I'll move.
How's he going to get his dick over there?
Yeah.
He'll
get it over there.
Have no fear.
Well, your idea is working here, but it's working with Benjy. You see what happens,
Benjy and Richard.
When you pitch.
I'll stand on the side.
Yeah,
we want to
make sure the camera can see it.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead, Benjy.
But
take
you're totally no disease.
What is that, Benjy?
I'm clean.
Oh my God.
Look.
I smell it.
Oh.
You smell it?
Someone take a still picture. This needs a still picture.
Look how funny.
Keep hitting him.
No,
Jason, get a picture.
That's a weird porno.
Look at that. A free cock to the face.
All thanks
punish
to
him with it. You know what your problem
Benjy.
Is? You have no dick, so you can't even punish it.
This is really
this could be you, my man.
It smells.
Does it smell,
does it
really?
It's a real distinct smell.
This could be you, my man.
All right, enough.
That's how you pitch an idea. Richard just keeps thrusting.
Did you get hard, Richard?
I started to feel hard.
I chubbed up a little, yeah.
From touching Benjy.
He's not gay.
Benjy, that was the best bit ever.
Thank you.
And
just got
and it came from my idea.
Well, that's what I'm trying. Benjy just actually proved a point.
All right, so I learned a lesson.
You pitch an idea and something comes of it.
Okay. And something
Benjy,
will
I'm
come of
sing
my
to you.
Ideas.
You're a hero.
What about me? It was my day.
Ah, we've seen that.
And I was the one who, started
Mariah Carey is singing. Do not speak over her. Look at Benjy, triumphant. If you reach into your soul. Reach into your soul, Benjy. Something really gay happening. Oh, my God.
What are you doing?
Benjy, wait, you didn't have to go this far. Are you holding his penis with your hand? What's going on right now?
It's a turn into a porno.
What is going on?
Richard's getting hard.
Benjy, what just happened? Richard, what happened?
He put my cock in his hand and was just holding it and
Benjy,
being nice to it.
Benjy?
What?
Why'd you do that?
I haven't been on the show in a while.
Airtime is his heroin.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
There it is.
Oh.
There it goes again.
Whenever
wait a second.
In the future, if I want to talk, can I just like this is like my mic?
All right, let go of his penis. I'm getting freaked out here. I don't know what's happening.
Howard, his dick definitely got bigger.
Are you getting hard?
I'll admit it did get a little bigger. Yeah.
You didn't have that much to slap Benjy with. Wait.
Is that thing hard as a rock?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. What is going on?
It's not hard, but it's chubbed. It's grew, yeah.
Wow.
Benjy has a nice hand.
Very soft.
Soft, yeah.
Benjy, you're a hero.
Thank you.
What just happened?
Well, for Benjy, let's go to commercial break with Mariah Carey singing Hero. This is for you, Benjy. There you go. You saved him. Looking so.